Hello students, welcome to the biology world. In previous video, we revised the first chapter, the living world. I hope you revised very well and you complete your worksheet. Now, I hope you have to note down for the first chapter, the living world, and you have to write without any doubt in term examinations. Now, today we discuss about the second chapter, that is biological classification. And when we revised that, in second chapter, biological classification, the name is classification is main topic of this chapter. All the living organisms are divided and classified into various taxonomic categories. Already we have to study the taxonomic categories in first chapter. So all the living organisms, either plants or either animals, divided or classified into various classification and various taxonomic categories with the basis of various characteristics. So, the biological classification now start the first two kingdom classification arise, and that is given by the Carolus Linnaeus. Linnaeus is divided into all the organisms into two types. So, it is known as two kingdom classification, that is plants and animal. So, the two kingdom is Plantae and Animalia. All the living organisms are divided into Plantae and Animal kingdom. So this is the classification is known as the two kingdom classification. Now the evolutionary phase, three kingdom classification, four kingdom classification, and last one, the RHB taker. The RHB taker is given five kingdom classification. And this five kingdom classification is the most important for your study. The five kingdom is, first one is Monera, second one is Protista, third one is Fungi, fourth one is Plantae, and fifth one is Animalia. All the living organisms are divided into two types, that is eukaryotes and prokaryotes. We have to know that what is the eukaryotes and what is the prokaryotes. In our body, various type of organelles are included, and the nucleus and nuclear membrane, it is the main organ of our body. In eukaryotes and prokaryotes, it is the divided into this way. So all the organelles are including eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cells. The nucleus and nucleus membrane is absent, so the genetic material is suspended in its cytoplasmic material. So this is the basic difference between eukaryotes and prokaryotes. Membrane of organelles like mitochondria, cell wall, chloroplast, Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, etc. organelles are absent or left in prokaryotic cells. As soon as eukaryotic cells are completely bounded by the membrane bound organelles. So, prokaryotes and eukaryotes, where the first kingdom is arise, that is Monera, all the prokaryotes are included. Prokaryotic organisms like bromelinae, bacteria, etc. are included in Monera. In Protista, eukaryotes organisms are included. In eukaryotes, there are also two types, unicellular and multicellular. Only one cell are included, and these cells are organized and work all the body organization. So this is known as unicellular organisms, and all cells are divided and create a new form, like a body to body, organ system level. So it is known as multicellular animals. So prokaryotes are two types, eukaryotes are two types, unicellular and multicellular. So all the unicellular eukaryotes are included in Protista. Single cell is formed, unicellular eukaryotes. In fungi, it is saprophytic organisms, because it is dependent on saprophytic or decaying organisms. Plantae, all the plants are autotrophs. And Animalia, it is heterotrophs. So this is the five kind of classification which is given by the R.H. Whittaker. The main criteria of R.H. Whittaker classification is the basic is cell wall, cell structure, nutrition, mode of nutrition. Third one is reproduction, structure of cell. This is the basic criteria of R.H. Whittaker, which is given by the five kingdom classification. So, in 5 marks, you have to ask, write down the short note in five kingdom classification, which is given by R.H. Whittaker. Now, we have to study the all the kingdom in detail. First, we discuss about the Monera kingdom. In Monera kingdom, all the prokaryotes are included. The best example and the familiar of the Monera is bacteria, mycoplasma, blue green algae, etc. It is the Monera kingdom. Now, the basic of the structure of the bacteria. Structure of the types of bacteria, it is divided into 4 types. Coccus, it is round shape. Bacillus, it is roll shape. Spirillum, it is look like spiral. And Vibrio, it is like coma shape. So this is the 4 types of bacteria basic on its structure. The bacteria are included in parasitic form, as well as some bacteria have photosynthetic also, because the chlorophyll like pigment is present. The bacteria are divided into 3 types, the archaebacteria. It is totally ancient bacteria. It is very much critical. It is observed in very much critical area, like very salty area, marshy area, and the ruminant area of the browsing animals. So this is the archaebacteria, or the ancient bacteria. Second one is Eubacteria. It is true bacteria and archaebacteria, Eubacteria and mycoplasma. Also chemobacteria, photosynthetic bacteria, etc. are included in various types of bacteria. In archaebacteria, the methanogens bacteria are very best examples, because it is present in a dump of the browsing animals and it is useful for the produce of biogas. So you have to write the short note on archaebacteria. So archaebacteria are 3 types, which is living in very hot condition. It is known as thermoacidophilus. It is live in marshy area. It is known as methanogens, and it is survive in very salty area. It is known as holophilus. So holophilus, thermoacidophilus and methanogens, 3 bacteria are included in archaebacteria, and you have to write in examination these 3 types of bacteria. In Eubacteria, it is true bacteria. Some bacteria, Eubacteria are like blue green algae, Nostoc, Enabina, have the capacity to synthesis atmospheric nitrogen gas in root of the plants. So this is a symbiotic relationship observed in Eubacteria. In Nostoc and Enabina, some special cells are present, which is known as heterocysts. In heterocyst, the nitrogen is nitrogen gas is stored, so it is very much useful for Eubacteria. Chemobacteria very much is useful because photosynthetic bacteria have chlorophyll like pigment, so it is prepare their own food. So Monera kingdom include the very much useful because the bacteria are useful in some medicines, in some bakery item also. So bacteria useful as well as it is very much harmful for our body because some bacteria are create disease in our body. It is reproduced by bacteria are reproduced by asexual and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is done by the fission method and sexual reproduction it is done by the some fertility factor is present in bacteria. Now we discuss about the second kingdom, that is protista. Here bacteria we have to discuss about the one bacteria, that is mycoplasma. Mycoplasma, it is a very smallest bacteria or smallest organism in Monera kingdom. Now we discuss about the second kingdom, that is protista kingdom. In protista kingdom, all the unicellular eukaryotes are included, like amoeba, paramecium, chlamydomonas, etc. are the unicellular protista. In protista, it is microscopic animal. Cell wall is present or absent in some type of organism. It is divided into four groups. First one is dinoflagellates. Second one is euglenoids. Ciliated and slime molds, and last one is protozoans. So this is the class of the protista kingdom. In protista kingdom, first one we discuss about the dinoflagellates. In dinoflagellates, you have to study that the soft box like cell wall is around there, and this cell wall is present in outer surface of the dinoflagellates. This cell wall is made up of silica, and silica cannot destroy. So the very vast cell wall is present in dinoflagellates habitat, and it is known as diatomaceous. Or also dinoflagellates is also included in your dinoflagellates. So dinoflagellates are very much useful because the cell wall we have to live in its habitat. It is very much useful for the filtration for syrup and polishing material. So it is very much useful dinoflagellates protists. Second one is euglenoids. Euglenoids, we have to know that euglena have photosynthetic like pigment and it is prepare their own food. It have like blue, green, yellow, etc. color because blue, green, yellow, various pigments are present in the euglenoids. In base example of euglenoids, it is euglena. In euglena, it is flagellated animals. And two flagella are present in euglena. So third is slime mold. Slime molds is a very much saprophytic animals. In slime mold, we have to study two types of arrangements. One is fruiting bodies is developed, and second one is the in unfavorable condition. It is look like surrounded the cyst formation. So the slime mold is saprophytic. And last one we have to discuss about the protozoans. Protozoans are various types because they are amoeboid protozoans, ciliated protozoans, flagellated and sporozoans. So amoeboid, ciliated and flagellated we have to know because amoeba-like structure or pseudopodia is present in amoeboid-like structure. In ciliated, the paramecium is present. In flagellated, trypanosoma, it is a very much sleeping sickness create disease in our body. And sporozoan, the malaria, the spore-like structure is present in their life cycle. And malaria, it is caused by the plasmodium virus. And this plasmodium virus is part of the sporozoan's protist. So this is the kingdom of protista. Now we discuss about the third kingdom, that is fungi. In fungi, we have to know that fungus are everywhere, and we all know and we all see about the various type of fungus in bread, in pickle, in some moist places. And this season, the monsoon season, is best for its survival. So various type of fungus we have to see in our surrounded area. The fungus is mostly present in moist places. The cell of the fungus is made up of polysaccharides and cellulose. So it is known as fungus cellulose. Fungus cellulose. The reproduction is done by the asexual and sexual. Both the sexual and asexual spores are produced. Various spores are produced during the asexual and sexual reproduction. Also, sexual reproduction is done by the three main stages, and it is important as in examination. The first one is plasmogamy. In plasmogamy, two motile or non-motile gametes are, protoplasm is fused. Second one is karyogamy. The two nucleus are fused. And third stage is meiosis. The haploid gametes are produced. So this is the three main steps: plasmogamy, karyogamy, and meiosis are occurring fungi. Asexual and sexual reproduction also are forming the spore produce. In last we have to discuss that the four main classes of the fungi. First one is Ascomycetes. Second one is Basidiomycetes. Third one is Phycomycetes. And fourth one is Deuteromycetes. The various examples are included in four classes. You have to ask in examination, write down the short note of any one classes. You have to also ask in examination, write down the examples of Ascomycetes or Basidiomycetes, Phycomycetes or Deuteromycetes. In this case, we have to also know that for Ascomycetes, Phycomycetes, Basidiomycetes and Deuteromycetes, four the classes are also known in the other name, like bracket fungi, puffballs, imperfect fungi. So you have to know which class included in puffball, in imperfect fungi. So in examination you have to remember the Deuteromycetes is also known as imperfect fungi. This is the ask in scientific reason. Give your scientific reason why Deuteromycetes is included in imperfect fungi. Because only asexual reproduction is occur. Sexual reproduction is not occur or observed in Deuteromycetes class. So four classes you have to prepare. Example is you have to prepare the basic information of fungus, that is hyphae, then mycelium, एंड कोएनोसाइटिक हाइफी. दिस इज द मेन वर्ड्स ऑफ द फंगस. द बॉडी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ फंगस इज नोन एज हाइफी. इफ द बॉडी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैव वेरियस सेप्टाइज प्रेजेंट एंड स्ट्रिप लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इट इज नोन एज माइसेलियम. And some mycelium have both the side is closed and nucleated protoplasm is present. It is known as coenocytic hyphae. So the network-like structure is known as mycelium. The nucleated cytoplasm is present. It is known as coenocytic hyphae. So this is the main word of the fungus, which is asking one marks question or define the word. So you have to prepare very well. Protista, fungi, and Monera kingdom. Now, so in RH Whittaker classification, we have to know that some acellular organisms like virus, lichens, and bureus do not include it. So it is we have to study the separate from the class RH Whittaker classification.